CPR. That toddler is alive and well. Fox 59's Brett Cass spoke with him about how he jumped into action. I can only imagine how he was feeling, how this family is feeling, this toddler.
Yeah, especially that family and another family as well. For first responders in Greenfield, it was the second call in just 1 week for a child unresponsive in a pool. But in both cases, people nearby were trained and knew exactly what to do.
Ready, set, go, 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 go!
It's true that not all heroes wear capes. Sometimes they wear straw hats.
Go, go, go!
If Andre Davis had a shy side, he sure doesn't show it. Especially around the Hancock County Boys and Girls Club.
Okay, Mason. Oh.
Here, he jumps into his role as Coach Davis, and when needed, he jumps into action.
And I noticed there was an additional whistle, and then an additional whistle, and saw a lifeguard flagging some folks over.
Davis and a group of about 65 kids were spending their Tuesday at Riley Park Pool in Greenfield when a 2-year-old boy was found in the water, unresponsive.
I realized we got to do it. We gotta make sure he's okay.
Davis and another woman took over the situation, giving the child CPR. Before first responders had arrived, they brought him back.
We did everything we could, and his eyes opened up, and he looked at me, and I knew we were doing okay.
Hop up, come on, come on, come on, come on.
To that child on that day, Davis was a hero.
And I'll get you a popsicle.
But to these kids, every day, Coach Davis is a hero.
Great future start here. And one wasn't going to end on my watch and not under my hands.
Now, in a few short months, Davis will be certified to teach CPR classes. But for now, if you are interested in being trained, you can contact your local fire department, police department, or the American Red Cross. Reporting here in the newsroom, I'm Brett Cass. In the studio, Brett Cass, Fox 59 News.
All right, Brett, thank you so much. Now, in addition to learning CPR,